In this video right now, I want to show you how Neville Goddard learned from his mentor how to apply the law of assumption and how Neville manifested his first goal consciously with applying the principle that his mentor told him and explained to him. So stick with me and learn how Neville learned. So with that, let's just dive right in. And this is what Neville said. I said to Abdullah in the month of October, Ab, you know, I have been gone from Barbados for almost 12 years. Now I have a haunting desire to go to Barbados. Not a thing stops me but the lack of money. I have no money. He said to me, you are in Barbados. I said, I'm in Barbados? Before we keep going with the story, I always want to point out, you know, some things here, because people oftentimes think that they have to be perfect at this, or that Neville was perfect at this, or that I'm perfect at this, or that I was perfect at it when I started, but that's not the case, right? Also, Neville here in the beginning, right, he took for granted what his senses told him, right? So he had no money, he lacked money, so therefore it was not logical for him, like, if I have no money, how can I go to Barbados, right? But his desire was, in his case, that he wants to travel to and be in Barbados, which is the, like, place where he was born, or where, like, his family lived back then. And his mentor, right, instead of saying, okay, then, you know, let's just find a way how you can get money, or what's the best idea coming to your head how you can, you know, make money right now? No, he said, you are in Barbados. And we will discover later why he said that and what that actually means. So then Neville, still very, you know, unsure what that means and didn't make sense to him back then, he said, I'm in Barbados. He said, yes, you are now in Barbados. And so you see Barbados and you see America from Barbados. This is already in a hint, or like going in the direction of thinking from, right? Seeing the world from the end state, right? So you see America from Barbados as though you would already be in America. You would already be in Barbados. So how would you see then America? It's not something that you're now in. It's something that you see as far away. And you can smell the tropical land of Barbados. See only the little homes of Barbados, and that's all you do. You simply sleep this night in Barbados. That's what his mentor told him. You sleep in Barbados, in your imagination, imaginatively, in your world, right? You sleep in your physical bed in America, but how would it feel like if you would close your eyes and already be in Barbados, already have achieved the end goal? Well, I thought him insane, really. I mean, at that moment, it seemed so stupid. Well, nevertheless, that night I slept in Barbados. Of course, not physically, but internally, right? I assumed that I'm in Barbados, in my mother's home, and that I saw America relative to Barbados. And it wasn't under me that night. It was north to me, about 2,000 miles. Well, the next day, I didn't tell him anything. About a week later, when nothing happened, I thought I would approach him. This time we've moved into November. Meaning, Neville did this, right? He did what his mentor told him, straight to the point, but there was no movement. There were no changes. His world still showed him that he is not in Barbados, right? So he got a little bit doubtful. Like, you know, usually we get in the beginning of his journey is we're not sure, am I doing it right? Is there more I need to do? What can I do to speed it up and all of that stuff? So I said, you know, Ab, so he went back to his mentor and he said, you know, Ab, there is not a thing has happened. So he expresses that nothing is changing, nothing has happened. He wouldn't discuss it with me. He turned his back on me and went into his little library and slammed the door. It's a very important part here. About three times I tried to open up a discussion with my friend Ab between that moment when I first talked to him and the end. He would never discuss it on the basis, how could he discuss with me how I'm going to Barbados when I'm already in Barbados? So we will learn right now in the next slides why his mentor Abdullah just slammed the door at Neville, why he didn't want to, you know, discuss with Neville how he can go to Barbados and why there is maybe no movement, because that would have brought, again, into Neville's awareness that it is not here yet, that you don't have it yet. But he, Abdullah, wanted to, you know, teach Neville a lesson that he should, like, be very persistent and bold and not accept no for an answer and only, you know, remain in his ideal until it's expressed and not discuss the means and why there isn't a movement and things like that. That's stupid to discuss how I'm going to go when I'm in Barbados. So Basically, his mentor wanted to help Neville to stay in the end state, to remain loyal in the unseen, hidden, unrevealed, yet unmanifested end state. That is what he wanted to do. And if I'm faithful to my assumption I can't discuss the how, I'm already there. Well, this went on. On the morning of the 4th day of December, there's no job, no place to go. So, you see, Neville thought that, you know, maybe he gets a new job where he makes more money or he finds, you know, an opportunity to go there, but nothing has changed yet. And the boat that will get me there by Christmas is going to sail on the 6th. So he was like very close to seemingly not manifesting it from his rational, logical point of view. Under my door is a little letter from my brother Victor. So in the letter, he justifies why he asks me to come. I know you don't have a job and there's no excuse for not coming. And so I'm enclosing a draft for $50. Meaning Neville got a letter from his brother Victor, who was compelled, who was, you know, in a sense, automatically activated to get the impulse to send Neville a letter with $50 in it and invite Neville. I rushed right up to Abdullah and said, "Ab, I got a ticket for Barbados, but I have to go third class." I'm all elated and happy about it. He said, his mentor said, "Who told you that you're going to Barbados? And who told you you went to Barbados third class? You went to Barbados and you went first class." Okay, see what he does here. He again wants to help Neville so that Neville places himself internally, already having went to Barbados. He already is there and he went first class. Instead of being like, "Oh yeah, I maybe got some signs, I got some movement. Well, maybe this could be the way for me." No, you went this way and this already happened. So I went down on the morning of the 6th day of December with my third class ticket, went up to the desk, and they're checking in the passengers. And I put my ticket forward and they said, "I've got good news for you, Mr. Goddard. Someone has canceled and you're going first class." He taught me by his rudeness that I cannot discuss how if I'm doing what I'm supposed to do. He tells me right away, "You are in Barbados." So again, you cannot discuss how is it going to happen, what is my next step, what should I do. You cannot be worried about the how, and I have many videos on my channel like on this how period, right, this gap from your current state to the wish fulfilled being manifested. I will link one of these videos above right now, where you see that in the end state, this denies all questions, this denies all worries, all fears, all doubts, and you cannot discuss the how in the end state. So by Abdullah's, Neville's mentor's rudeness, he helped Neville to stay bold and confirm and stable in the end state. He said, "You are in Barbados," and just apply this for your own life circumstance, right? Maybe you don't have the desire to go to Barbados, but you have any other desire for any other life circumstance, any other life area. And instead of working out a way, worrying about how it's going to happen, your mind and rational mind maybe comes up with two or three ways. But instead of being engaged in those limitations, why not, you know, focus on dwelling in the end state, what it would be like. Imagine something that implies you are already there. Like Neville did, he placed himself imaginatively in the bed of his mother's home, of his family's home, and slept there internally to feel the naturalness of already actually being there. And that then started this bridge of unfolding, which eventually also, you know, that's why he got this that letter from his brother, who was in a sense compelled to act automatically to play part of Neville's bridge to get Neville where he wanted to be. I'm in New York City physically, but he put me, like Abdullah, put me in Barbados in my imagination. So Abdullah helped Neville so that Neville can place himself internally in his imagination in the end state, which in this case is Barbados. So that I slept in Barbados to the best of my ability. But you know, days go into weeks and the weeks went into a month, and I'm trying my best to open the discussion with him to get a little hope. No hope, right? Abdullah would not give Neville any hope. Like, "Oh yeah, that's good. Yeah, good. Your brother reached out. Good. Yeah, that's movement." No, you're already there. You're already in the end. "I don't care if your brother reached out. That could be part of the bridge. Yeah, but I don't care. You are already in Barbados. You're already in the end state. It is already in existence. Otherwise, Neville could have not even imagined that. So it is already there. You are already there." He wouldn't give me any encouragement if I did what he told me to do, Well, we are all human enough to want another little discussion, another little push, right? And be honest with yourself. I'm also honest with myself, of course, right? We sometimes want this little check-in. We want this little assurance that we're doing it right, that we're on the right path, that we, you know, that this movement means something, that we're like on the right track. That's normal, but not super helpful. And so he taught me the lesson that there is not such a thing as a little pregnancy. Not such a thing. If you did it, then you're pregnant, right? If you shift into the end state, you shift into the end state. If you dwell right now in the end state, you are there. You experience it. It is done in you. Let the child grow. Any interference with it is going to be a miscarriage. You assume that you are in Barbados. Now you're pregnant. The idea is that you're going to give birth to a journey which will land you right in Barbados. So you've assumed it, right? So again, let's translate this. You assume that you have now your desire, right? What would it be like? What would it feel like? How would I see the world? What would someone say to me? What would I do differently? You can imagine that. You can feel into that. You can dwell in that. You can make this alive in you. And now you're pregnant, aka now you have realigned yourself within you, have shifted into a new state, right? Something new started to become natural and certain for you. And then the idea is that you're going to, or the law is basically that you're going to give birth to a journey, aka a bridge of incidents is going to start to unfold, because within you stand here, externally you still stand here, but your outer life, your circumstances, your mirror of life always needs to reflect back where you stand within. So things that you can't logically understand will happen to also reflect back to you externally where you stand within, which is in Barbados. So in Neville's case, he got a letter. He was invited to come to Barbados. He even got the money for the trip. So it all happened. But Neville could have never thought that, okay, this is how it's going to happen. Now, I don't argue. You have conceived. And all you have to do is to be a faithful mother and bear that child and don't discuss it with me anymore. So the statement, the summary is this. It is done. It is done, right? Here and now. So how does that feel to you? That's the only question you need to ask yourself, right? It is done. First of all, also I have many videos on my channel about that. You could not even have a desire for something that does not exist as a potential, that is not available as an opportunity, a potential, something that is possible for you, a possibility. So having a desire already means that you can dwell on the wish fulfilled for that certain desire. So having a desire means that it's something that's available. But as long as you remain in the state of desiring it and seeing it as separate and hoping for it and waiting for it, you can never express it. So you have to see the world from already having achieved the desire, from already being it. What would it feel like? What would it be like? Have other people congratulate you on it. Have imaginary scenes that imply it to you. What would happen the day after, the next day, once you got your desire? But the core learning is that the feeling of the wish fulfilled is in you. It's done. You can dwell on the mood of the wish fulfilled here and now. So the wish fulfilled happens in you, in your awareness, in your inner reality. And the external world, the mirror, can then confirm what you did in yourself. As within, so without. Right. So how does it feel to you right now to know that you already have your desire and that it is completely done, that it is yours right now? Ask yourself that. All right. So that's it from my side on this video. Again, Neville learned this law in a very beautiful way, because back then people didn't have, 10,000 YouTube channels on manifesting teachings, 10,000 TikTok and Instagram accounts and all of that, right? They had just people that they talked to. And if they said, this is how it is, just do it like this, they could not, get more encouragement from social media and all of that. They just needed to follow what someone told them. So this was amazing back then, right? They weren't overwhelmed by all of these pings and impulses. So if you feel overwhelmed right now in your manifesting journey, then what I did basically with my program, should that be relevant for you, is I condensed all that hype and fluff and woo-woo and overload of information that's out there into a step-by-step system surrounded by a community, one-on-one support, weekly calls with me, a step-by-step system, like I said, so that you really can move forward, internalize, apply, and succeed with these teachings and, move to your goals. So if that is relevant for you, you want my help, then just schedule a free call with me or my team so that we can get to know you, figure out if we can help you, I'll give you a game plan, and if you are all good fit, then we can start on my program. And if not, then at least, you got to know me or my team. So there's zero thing that you need or that you can lose here. Or you can also check out my free masterclass, of course, that's also in the video description and pinned comments. Thanks for tuning in. Let me know your feedback on the story from Neville in the comments down below. I think, again, it's a beautiful story. That's how Neville learned the law. And then he, you know, applied it again and again and again. He got out of army and he manifested to marry his wife by applying the same law, right? By first assuming that within, by first dwelling on the state of having it, of being it within, via his imagination, via consciously tuning into making this state alive within him. And then the outside world as a confirming mirror reflected that back in a delayed way. So you see, Neville slept in Barbados this one night and made it alive in him, but it took some weeks to then, you know, got his brother to be compelled to send him this letter. So externally is delayed, internally you can right now be in the end. So there's no more waiting. You have it right now. It's done here and now. How does it feel that you are right now who you want to be? So that's it. Speak to you soon, guys. Bye.